Today's lecture we shall start with the three-dimensional geometry. In this we shall be covering the basics of 3D transformations. It is the similar type of concept that we have already applied with the 2D transformations, and we are just going to increase the dimension, that is three dimensions we shall be now working, and we shall try to take up some problems, numerical problems that we have attempted in the class. Same type of numerical problems we shall now take up in this video lecture. So let us start with the 3D dimensions. In this particular three-dimensional model, you will have a point is represented with the help of three coordinates, x, y, and z, and this is the parameter which is to be included, which is generally kept as one homogeneity, homogeneous coordinate system we have to build up. So we will be using x dash by h, y dash by h, z dash by h, and one. And this value of 1 is generally kept as unity. Now this point is multiplied, or it is here it is not mentioned here. T is the transformational matrix. This transformational matrix is represented here. Now let us see some of the slides that we have to see go through in this particular topic. Let us start with the first slide. I shall rub the board and then it will make the things more clear in the slides. Now if you look at this transformation concept, we have already started with the this is the first slide, 3D transformations. We shall be covering translation, scaling, rotation with quadrants, transformations, and coordinate transformations. All these topics shall be covered in these 3D transformations. Though some of the topics, these are three first three topics we have already covered in the 2D transformations as well. So similar in nature and involve a similar type of concept. So we shall be handling that one also. So here, let us start with the first one. Now this is the transformational matrix representation. Here A, B, C, 0, 0. And this is 3 cross 3. This is 3 cross 1. 1 cross 1, 1 cross 3. Now this 3 cross 3 scaling, reflection, sharing, rotation matrices will be there here. 3 cross 1 here, we shall have translational parameters, uniform global scaling, 1 cross 3 homogeneous representation, 1 cross 3 here. 1 cross 1 uniform global scaling. So let us start with the transformation process one by one. Let us see the first thing, that is translation. Translation is a process by which we move an object from one location to the other, which means that each and every coordinate position is going to be affected. Now in this particular case, since we are talking about three dimensions, all the three dimensions of that particular object will be affected here as shown here. It is x dash equals to x plus px, and y dash equals to y plus py, z dash equals to z plus tz. Now in this particular case, let us see the previous position and the translational parameter that is to be added. This is the previous y position and this is the translational parameter. This is the translational parameter in the z direction. Now if you see this particular diagram here, in this particular diagram you see that there is an object here, and this object is being moved from one location to the other by adding the translational parameters, and the new position is shown here, and here the x dash, y dash, z dash, and 1, this is the representation of the new coordinates that will be obtained by the object, and this is 100px. Now all the translational parameters px, py, and tz are in this particular column, and this is the previous coordinate position values here. Now these two matrices are multiplied and then the final result is obtained, which we can see through the representation in a graphical format. Now the second thing. Now let us start with the second thing, that is called as uniform scaling. In the case of uniform scaling, you are multiplying with the coordinate scaling parameters sx, sy, and sz. So how can we find out the coordinates? X dash is equals to x, sx, y dash is equals to y, sy, z dash is equals to z sz. So here these are scaling parameters which are to be multiplied, and this is the representation method of the scaling transformation, which is multiplied with the original coordinates, and then we get the final output coordinates. Now suppose we have got this object of translation, the scaling scaled object will be this one, but each and every coordinate has to be multiplied with this. Okay, so that we have to see how we can do that, and this is the multiplication only for first, only for the one coordinate. Now this is the scaling transformation that we have already discussed in the class also. Now let us take up the next thing, that is the relative scaling. The term relative scaling here, scaling with the selected fixed position. Now in this particular case, this is the original position, this is the translation of the object, and this is the scaling and inverse translation. Now this is with respect to a selected position. So here you can see that this is the translation, this is the scaling, and this is the inverse representation. Here all the three things, this is represented as P, XF, YF, ZF, SX, SY, SZ, inverse translation, minus XF, minus YF, minus ZF. So we have to first multiply these things. Like it has been represented here, three matrices. The things become easier if you multiply first all these three matrices, and then you multiply the corresponding point. Then it will make the things little bit less cumbersome, and the results will be more accurate, and there will not be any mathematical calculations also. Mathematical problem, unwanted results will not be there. So first you multiply all these three transformation matrices, and then you try to get the things. So let us start with the 3D rotation. We will be subsequently dealing with the numericals also, one by one, after we finish these things, and I will take up some numericals here for today. Now 3D rotation, coordinate axis rotation, x axis rotation, y axis rotation, z axis rotation. These are the three things that we have, two things we have already done, x and y axis rotation, but now we, this is another component, three directional. So general 3D rotations, rotation about an axis that is parallel to one of the coordinate axis, rotation about an arbitrary axis. So let us take these points one by one. Let us talk about, say, the 3D rotation first. I'll give you the matrices for 3D rotation, and then we'll proceed further. Let us write first the matrices. Now this particular matrix, this is for rotation transformation, and this rotational transformation is about the x-axis, and we can see here, this is the rotational transformation matrix, and now how to attempt the problems. Now this is the transformational matrix here represented by this. We will be given certain values of theta, and we will have to put those values of theta in this particular matrix, and then we have to multiply individually the matrices. So let us take one problem, that is a given rectangular parallelogram, and the dimensions are, let us write the dimensions here, 0, 0, 1, So this is particularly rectangular parabolic given to us, and now we want to translate. This is rotation along x-axis. We can put it here, rotation along x-axis. So how can we do that? Now let us see the problem. Now this particular problem can be solved as we can write like this: x star equals to p and x and p. So the value of x is here, this one, and value of p is here. We have to put this value, and then we have to multiply this. Now suppose we are given the value of theta as say 90 degree. We can say theta is equals to say minus 90 degree, and then we can put these values here. How to just write? You first fill up these values here in this particular matrix, solve this particular matrix, then start multiplying. So it will make the things slightly easier, and then only you will be able to do this. This is the rectangular parallel of light which has been multiplied with the coordinates of a three-dimensional rotational transformation in x direction. Now in this case, three-dimensional rotational transformation, we can see that the matrix, if we put the values here for this particular matrix, we can find out that this is equal to 1 0 0 and 0 0, and then we have cos of minus 90, sine of minus 90, 0 0, minus sine minus 90, and then cos minus 90, 0, 0, 0, 0, and 1. So we can solve this, and we can write down the things. Cos 90, we can correspondingly write these particular values, 0, and this particular value, minus 1, and this particular value, 1. And this particular value we can put 0. So we have solved this particular matrix. Now we will be multiplying this with this particular matrix. Let us see if I put it here. So how does it look like? It will be 1 0 0 0 0 minus 1 0 0 1 0 and 0 0 0 0 and 1. Now let us multiply this and then see the results for us. In this particular case, now we have to multiply the things. Equals to, now this whole row is to be multiplied here. This whole row is to be multiplied with this column. This whole row is to be multiplied with this column. This whole row is to be multiplied with this column. So how can we write? I'll solve a few rows for you. Now if we see here 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 0, so it will be 0. If we multiply this one again with this one, it will be 0, this again 0, then this is 1 and this is 0. So here we have 1. 0, 0, 0, and 0. If you multiply this one here, we get 1 here. So next, 3, multiply into this one, this is 3, then since rest of all 0, so nothing will be there. 3, 0, it is going to be 1, and this for this particular thing will be 0, and this for this particular thing will be 1. Okay, so you can see the results how I am doing this. Similarly, this third row, I will just finish the three rows and then we will subsequently shift over to the next problem. The reason is whole of the matrices to be multiplied and then finally we have to check the results for us. Okay, so now next one, this 3, then this, nothing is here, all are zeros, so all will be 0, here 3, and then we have here 1. In this case, it is 2 minus 2 rather, because this is minus 2, and then this one will be 1. So you will be getting some 8 rows, and subsequently you will fill up these all values, and then you will get the final new rectangular parallelogram pipe, which is rotated in the x direction. So we can see the another matrix and the y direction. Then I'll show you the slides. So let us see the another transformational matrix, which is the rotation in the y direction. So let us see how it can be represented here. The transformational matrix in y direction, it will be something like this: cos of phi 0 minus sine of phi 0 and 0, 1, 0, 0, sine of phi 0, cos phi 0, 0, 0, 0 and 1. This is rotation in y direction. This is the rotational transformation matrix in y direction. Similarly, we can write the rotational transformation matrix in z direction. We have already learned about x direction. So we will see here. The rotation along z direction can be represented as cos phi 0, sorry, cos phi sine 0, 0 minus sine psi cos psi 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0 and 1. So this is rotation along z direction. So the formula remains the same. So how do you calculate the new coordinate values? X r equals to x into t. Now this rotation matrix will be there, rotational matrix, and this rotational matrix, it will be either x rotational matrix, it will be or y directional rotational matrix, or z directional rotational matrix. So the methodology remains the same. First of all, you have to remember the coordinate matrices representation in the three directions, and after that we have to just put the values of the particular angle and then find out the transformational values in that particular matrix, and then you multiply with the object, 3D object that is given to you. So you will get the new values of the coordinates. So let us take up how it can be seen in the slides. Let us see in the slides. Here, let us rub this first. So let us see next thing. Here you can see. So Z rotation, X axis rotation, and Y axis rotation. We have already learned this. So let us talk about some few examples further. Let us talk about say the next topic, that is the scaling, how this scaling can be performed, and let us see the concept. The scaling matrix is already discussed. The scaling can be represented by the scaling matrix, and the values will be given to us. Let us take one problem here. In this particular problem, let us say we are given a rectangular value of y, and we want to construct the say after scaling, how will the object look like. So let us take one object here. So here there is an object. This is the Y Z and X A B C D. So now this is the rectangular parallel pipe given to us, and now we want to perform the scaling transformation on this particular object of our interest. So let us see what are the values that are given to us. We will write those values for this particular thing, that is 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 0, 1, 1. 2, 3, 1, 1, 0, 3, 1, 1, then 0, 0, 0, 1, then 2, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 0, 3, 0, 1. Now this is the particular coordinate values of this particular rectangular pipe are given to us, and now we want to perform the scaling transformation of this particular object, and the scaling parameters that are given are the scaling parameters given to us are 1 by 2, 1 by 3, let us say Sx and Sy. So let us do this. It is given here. First of all we will write down the matrix. The matrix can be written as 1 by 2, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1 by 3, 0, 0, and we are given here 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, and 1. Now this is the transformational matrix for scaling. Okay. Now for scaling, now the formula remains the same. Now we want to perform X, and here it is T. Formula remains the same. This is your X, this value, and this is your T. So we will multiply and we will get the object. Now let us see how this can be done here. The given values are Sx, and here this is the values Sx, Sy, and Sz. These values are given to us, and now we want to multiply, and the results will be this whole row will be multiplied by this column, this whole row will be divided by all these columns. So let us see the first one. Since these both are zeros, so this first one will be zero. It will be here. Let us write. It will be 0, 0, and 1, and 1. Because if you see here, this is 0 and this is 1 and this is also 1 here. Now similarly for this one, if you 2 and a half, this is 1 and 0, then 1 and then 1. 0, 0. Sorry. This is 1 and then 1. Similarly, you can get write the other values. So scaling operation can be performed. The scaling also involves the dimensions. And now how the object looks like, suppose we have already multiplied, and how the object looks like, let us see. So here, let's say the object looks like. So let us see the object. It will be something. So this kind of scaling operation will be there. Scaling. Now all the things will be A star, here B star, F star, D star, H star, B star, C star. So scaling is a process by which we scale an object originally given to us by using the matrix multiplications. So today we have attempted the rotation, translation and scaling in three dimensions, and we have also learned about the basics of matrix multiplications, how the matrix multiplication will be there, and then we have to first, the basic target of this particular 3D geometric transformation is, first of all, you should be able to represent the original object on the x, y and z, and first of all represent the object, then you perform the mathematical calculations with the help of the representation of matrices, and then multiply the matrices and get the final result. Then if you have, once you have obtained the final result of multiplication, then you have to re-represent the transformed object onto the x-axis. So we have done, in this particular class we have attempted the translation, rotation, all the three matrices have been given to you, so you have to remember those three matrices: translation in x-axis, translation in y-axis and translation in z-direction.
and we have also learned about translation in rotation in x direction and rotation in y direction and rotation in z direction. Different vertices are there, you have to remember that. Scaling is also a process that we have learned, in which each and every coordinate of the object is multiplied with the sx, sy and sz parameters, that those are called as scaling parameters, and those scaling parameters are multiplied with the each and every coordinate, and then you get the transformed object, as we have seen in this particular diagram here. If you see a rectangular parallelogram, you are scaling the object since it is almost reduced considerably to half of the original size, since the values of sx and sy are in the reduction side. So it is automatically represented here, so you can see the results.